For the function f of x, y equals inverse sine of the quantity x squared plus y squared minus 10, the domain of the function is a set of all points on two circles and the area between two circles. We're asked to determine the radius of the larger and smaller circle. Recall the domain of a function of two variables is a set of all possible inputs. For the function f of x, y, the domain is a set of all possible ordered pairs x, y. Remember, when we have a function of one variable involving the inverse sine function, for example, y equals inverse sine of x, the domain, or set of all possible inputs, or x values, are all the possible sine function values, indicating the domain is the closed interval from negative 1 to positive 1. And the output, or range, or possible y values, are the angles in the closed interval from negative pi over 2 to positive pi over 2. So applying this to the given function of two variables, we know the inputs of x squared plus y squared minus 10 must be in the closed interval from negative 1 to 1. And therefore, x squared plus y squared minus 10 must be greater than or equal to negative 1 and less than or equal to positive 1, which we can state using this compound inequality. But let's break this up into two inequalities. Remember, we can read this type of inequality starting in the middle and reading to the left, as well as starting in the middle and reading to the right. And this would be an and compound inequality. So in red, we have x squared plus y squared plus 10 is greater than or equal to negative 1. Notice the inequality is still pointing toward the negative 1. And in blue, we have x squared plus y squared plus 10 is less than or equal to 1. And now solve both of these inequalities for x squared plus y squared by adding 10 to both sides. And now simplifying on the left, we have x squared plus y squared is greater than or equal to positive 9. And on the right, x squared plus y squared is less than or equal to 11. These inequalities should remind us of the equation of a circle in the form of x squared plus y squared equals r squared, which is a circle centered at the origin with a radius r. If we wanted to graph x squared plus y squared greater than or equal to 9, we would first graph the circle x squared plus y squared equals 9, which is a circle centered at the origin where r squared equals 9, and therefore the radius is 3. And then we would shade outside the circle because of the greater than or equal to inequality symbol. And then to graph x squared plus y squared less than or equal to 11, we would first graph the circle x squared plus y squared equals 11, indicating we have a circle where r squared equals 11, and therefore the radius r is equal to the square root of 11. And then we would shade inside the circle because of the less than or equal to inequality symbol. And because we have an and, the overlapping region would be the solution, or in this case, the domain of the given function. And since the square root of 11 is larger than 3, we know the radius of the larger circle is square root of 11, and the radius of the smaller circle is 3. Let's take a look at this graphically. Again, the domain of the given function f of x, y would be all the points on these two circles, as well as all the points in the area between the two circles. The larger circle has a radius of square root of 11, and the smaller circle has a radius of 3. I hope you found this helpful.